Meow. Meow. Meow are ya? Game Cat Fat Acrobat here, and you're watching Viewer Takeover. What? You've never seen a cat with a sombrero and a mustache before? And a gold chain and an eye patch?
No. No, I have not seen that before. Let's please just start the show.
This is the Midnight Gamescast, where we record every Monday night at, no, every Tuesday afternoon at midnight, and then we bring it to YouTube every Wednesday as a weekly wrap-up, every Thursday as PlayStation VR Theater, and every Friday, that's every today, as Viewer Takeover. That's when we let you, the loyal Gamecats, we let you take over the show. Basically, we scour the comments, and we find our favorites, and then we read them on air, and then we respond to them, and we make one of them.
Yes.
To be honest. And then we add question marks where they don't belong.
No.
Because that's what we do.
So yeah. I'm Brian. Why that's not? Jeremy. And this is Michelle. And this is Viewer Takeover. We want to thank right off the bat Fat Acrobat for that fucking amazing introduction. The dude is awesome.
Yeah.
Get on.
Target. No, I was thinking the patrons.
Dude. So Fat Acrobat's the same guy who did the Game Cats or Game Dinosaurs.
Mm-hmm.
You guys remember that?
Yeah.
Yep. That was great. Hilarious. The guy's got a great sense of humor.
Yeah.
He sent me a couple variations on the introduction today. We chose the one that was less offensive, the one without Hitler. Yeah, I'll show you guys that one later.
Oh, yeah.
But yeah, no, Michelle is right. There are some very important people in our lives that we'd like to thank. Thank you very much. These are our loyal Patreon supporters. These are the people who give us anywhere from a dollar to infinite amounts of money every single month. And Jeremy, why don't you tell us what those people get for their dollar or more every month?
Well.
Oh, God.
Oh, my God.
They get access to a little insight on, a talent of ours, or some personal issues of ours, or whatever it might be. But each week we each have our own little segment where we get to talk to you guys about whatever we want. Show your talent, talk about shit. Yeah, a little bit. Yeah. And, anywhere from 3 to 20 40. Some, 30, 40 minutes. Yeah.
I went on way too long.
That's all right.
Yeah, we make a video every week.
It was only 15 this time. It wasn't long.
Yeah, every week one of us makes a video for you guys, the loyal Patreon supporters. So for just a dollar a month on patreon.com/withoutparolegames, you can also be part of all of those videos. And if you give us a dollar, like right now, you get access to all of the ones.
No, all of them. Months.
All of them.
Yeah.
You get months of, like 20 episodes, basically.
Yeah.
Right. Of
we've been doing it a while now, huh?
Yeah. Mine was the 21st one. The first four are free, so that means there's like 16 videos or 17 videos you haven't seen of us. Talking about our personal lives. So it's not PlayStation VR related for the most part. It's more personal stuff.
Right.
Mm-hmm. Most of you probably aren't interested in that, so see you later.
Yeah.
Goodbye.
This is Viewer Takeover.
That's the one.
Here we go. We're going to read some comments, and we're going to respond to them. First one comes from Fuzzy Duo on the Skyrim Breaking News Report. This is a popular video for some of our new subscribers.
Yes.
This is something that brings people in all the time. It's old news, which is strange.
Yeah.
Fuzzy Duo writes, I never used the Move controllers. They are AIDS. And he put AIDS in all capital letters. I can only assume he means
autoimmune deficiency syndrome.
That's the one. Yeah. It's always either DualShock 4 or aim controls. We need to keep sending angry feedback on the official Sony forums and in feedback emails demanding new Move controllers, or they won't make them?
Yeah, I mean, will they?
dude, Fuzzy Duo, we obviously respect your opinion, everyone else's opinion. Unfortunately, you're wrong. The Move controls, for being 7-year-old tech, are pretty unbelievable. If you played Super Hot or any other amazing Spark, these things, they're not perfect for the games we want, like Skyrim.
Yeah,
hopefully there are new Move controls coming for that. But in the meantime, if you're not using Move controls, you're missing out on some amazing games that require Move controls. So don't I mean, if you just keep waiting, you might never get what you're looking for.
Yeah.
Right.
And I don't think angry feedback is the way to go.
That doesn't get you anything.
Yeah. We definitely need to, you know, keep letting Sony know what we want. But mm-hmm. let's be nice about it.
Yeah.
Right. Let's do that. I want cool, like, anklets and bracelets so that they can actually track your entire body as you move. I think that would be awesome.
He or she will be able to probably experience that in the future. Probably. But us, unfortunately,
find out soon.
Yeah.
15th.
Hey, really?
Mm-hmm.
Wow.
A little BJ.
It's a little BJ.
No, it is
a
little BJ. That is not the name.
No.
Jeremy, you're up.
I am. Is this Velp?
That's what I was thinking, Velp.
Yep, from the Super Hot review.
Super.
First game I played on my PSVR. Best I've ever felt in my life. Beats sex.
Whoa.
Hands down? I disagree.
All right, hold on. Whoa, whoa, whoa.
Yeah.
I wouldn't say that it beats sex.
I mean, it depends. I mean, depends who on you having sex with.
Right.
That is the... Yeah.
Is that the question?
Beast? Or beast sex? Maybe that's why.
However, first game was Super Hot on VR. That's an incredible start.
It's an incredible start. The problem is, of course, if Super Hot's your first game, a lot of
it
other games are going to seem like
a
big letdown.
Yeah.
In comparison.
Yeah, Dez is having the same problem. We started him off with some amazing, amazing games, and now he's trying to go
back
and play like, are you kidding me? Dying Reborn?
This game's right.
Trash.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Right.
It was nice to start right in the beginning and play, see the transition, you know, as we grew a little, but...
Yeah,
Super Hot is phenomenal, though.
Super Hot is phenomenal.
Someday I'll play
hands down.
I don't agree with the better than sex statement, but you know, great game for sure.
Teach your own.
Yeah.
All right, Francis Hollins, The Lost Bear review. I left you guys a DM on your Instagram. Long story short, I was thinking of doing some fan art for you guys, but then it occurred to me, it'd be awesome if I could instead do something which you could use on your channel.
So the reason I included this, Francis Hollins, we did see your Instagram message. It got lost in the shuffle at some point. I apologize for that. But what's been happening lately? You know, we have Benjamin Tay. You know, from BenjaminTay.com. Nah, it's probably just in the description. I don't know.
Yeah.
He didn't say, hey, I've got fan art, or hey, I want to do this for you, because what happens is if you send me that kind of email and you go, hey, I want to do something for you, I'm gonna go, great, and then I'll never get back to you, because I'm too busy trying to just maintain what we have.
Yeah.
And so if you want to do something, honestly, just do it.
Yeah.
And send it along.
Yeah.
Because that's what Benjamin Tay did. That's what Dan Watson did. Dan Watson did the amazing new curtains and the popcorn for the PlayStation VR theater introduction, but he didn't ask, what can I do?
Right.
He goes, I'm an animator and I did this for you. And I went, thank you, sir.
Like,
yeah.
Yes.
Right? Because if you...
Thank you.
Right, because I'm never going to be like, hey, I think you should create a new introduction for us.
Yeah.
Or, hey, maybe create a new logo for us. Just
we didn't even think about getting a new curtain.
No,
we
didn't even think about it.
But now that we see the new curtain, we're like,
did we
want that?
Yeah.
I didn't even want the old curtain.
Right.
Like, this wasn't even the thing. And then, like, one day I had just, like, an extra 20 minutes, and I was like, let's make a curtain.
Fine.
Now you got to do it.
Now
we
got to do it.
Now there's popcorn. It's a mess.
A whole thing.
It used to be real easy to edit this podcast, and now it's a fucking 3-day.
Now you're going to have to do ending credits.
At least you don't
now
have to do true
giving...
and false anymore. That was a lot of editing. Ding.
That was a lot of editing.
Mm-hmm.
Man, oh man. Speaking of, So, Francis, thank you for
thank you for
the comment. Thank you for wanting to do that. Again, if it's something you want to do, if it's something you think that our channel is missing, just send it along, and and you know,
maybe we'll include it.
Maybe we will. I can't promise you that we will. We've gotten some stuff from people that we haven't used, and those people we apologize to, but we can't take everything.
Right.
Yeah.
You know, otherwise it's just going to be all you guys
chaos.
And none of us.
Yeah.
Right.
So next up is Stephen Ward from Viewer Takeover. He wrote, I'm with you, Brian. Spelled wrong, by the way, dude. I think I've been waiting for VR since I was a kid in the 70s. I wasn't a real heavy gamer, but bought into a few consoles over the years, but have always been missing something. I think VR is what I've been missing and absolutely love it. Also, keep up the great work, all of you. Stephen, the reason I included this is because, in case anybody's new to this channel, you'll know, I just wanted to reiterate that I was kind of losing interest in video games. I was always going to play video games for the rest of my life, but not with the passion that I have my whole life.
All of a sudden.
You know? Oh, yeah. Anytime there's a new...
Sorry.
Anytime there was... Yeah, polar bears. anytime there was a new console, I was always super excited. I couldn't wait to see what the new console generation would bring. You know, oh, check out these new amazing graphics. Oh, check out what this game can do that the last, you know, game couldn't, kind of thing. And then around the time that PlayStation 4 launched, I was like, eh.
Now what?
Hey.
Everything's the same, just looks better. Right. You know?
Like, some of the games were really cool. I was like, oh, Bloodborne's fantastic, you know? I was like, I love playing Bloodborne.
Yeah.
You know? And like, even, like, Assassin's Creed 4 was fantastic. But, like, I've just, like, I've done all this before in different forms.
Yeah.
And then the second VR came out, it just changed our life and changed the channel. Like, I think you see a dramatic difference from the from October.
Completely changed the channel.
From October of last year, like, everything, we got way more passionate about filming, about you know, we had to break news reports and got, you know, we ramped up the reviews and Let's Plays and everything, because suddenly I was really passionate about gaming again, and PlayStation VR specifically is to thank for that.
Yeah.
So if you guys, you know why we focus on PlayStation VR, it's that reason. It's because it's the thing that got us back into gaming, the thing we care most about for games. We still play other games.
Oh, yes.
There are many other games. I just got Everybody's Golf in the mail, and or last week, and it's still in the cellophane, but that's been something I've been waiting for.
I'm taking that with me when
no,
I
No, you're not, actually.
Xenoblade 2 on Switch. I'm very excited for that.
When's that coming?
Couple of months. It's this year. I forget exactly when, because Skyrim's first. And then next, will be my next game
we'll
after that.
We'll deal with Skyrim first. Yeah.
Yeah.
All right. Ready?
I am ready.
All right.
This is from the Lost Bear Review. This is...
Mm-hmm. Good luck.
Ed Ulinares?
Yeah, we'll go with that. It's on the bottom of the screen. Don't worry.
Okay. Oh, come on! Another one-hour-long experience? Developers, why do you continue to do this? Mm-hmm. Make some true games with proper duration and replayability, for God's sake? I mean, if you believe in God, yeah.
What do you guys think about these one-hour experiences in VR?
So I agree with him on that. There's a lot of experiences, you know? It is still new. We just tend to think...
I told you need a coaster, damn it.
Yeah, he does need a coaster.
Get out of control.
Would you like to use my skirt?
No, I'm good. Holy crap.
Well, yeah, take it off. And we'll just wipe the counter down.
Thank you very much. We're on your side.
Yes. But, yeah, I agree with him. There's a lot of experiences. And people want more. And I think we tend to forget that a lot of people don't have VR. You know, so it's kind of like one of those things. Well, we know it, but you know what I'm saying. Like... We're wanting more experiences, but there's still people out there that need these little pushes into the world of VR. So on a developer side...
Sure, but how many do we need?
Yeah. Well, I mean, you know, this is still new technology for the most part. Not many people have it. But, yeah, I want longer games. Yeah. Yeah.
I definitely want longer games.
Yeah.
This is The Lost Bear specifically was by Oddbug Studios and Fabric, and both very small companies. Mm-hmm. So the thing I've always been harping on about with VR is that we've got a lot of small indie developers who we should be thrilled, first of all, that they're making VR games, right? Because these guys probably don't have the money to make a full-fledged, even 8-hour game, right? So they had, this is what we can give you, this is the budget that we have. So I would rather have this, The Lost Bear was fantastic, I'd rather have it exist at 1 hour long than not exist at all. And if everyone buys it, and it's priced appropriately, it's only like $12.99 or something like that, and even on sale for the first week, I believe.
Yeah.
So it's one of those things where, like, if enough people buy The Lost Bear, then Oddbug and Fabric will suddenly have more money to make their next game. And if we show them support and say, hey, so, you know, we like your game, then now they have more money to build maybe a 4 or 5 hour game next time. Right? And then we buy the 4 or 5 hour game, and then they have even more money to buy to make, you know, the 8 to 10 hour game. And then suddenly this little indie developer becomes, you know, like a B tier developer, then becomes like an A.
Right.
And then in like a decade we'll have a AAA developer that's making VR games for us.
So we need these 1 hour experiences.
I guess if the price point matches the experience length, then it might be a little more acceptable. People are probably getting a little frustrated because they're paying top dollar for experiences.
Right.
You know?
And I don't want anybody to buy something they don't want in the hopes that this same developer will give us something that we do want in a few years.
Yeah.
That's not what I'm trying to say. I'm saying that is my hope for this developer,
it's
that people will buy it. And it is, the price point is appropriate. And it's, you know, we've got so many scary games coming.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
We've got so many puzzle games coming. We've got so many, like, kind of, not generic, but things we've seen over and over in VR already. And it's been less than a year. The Lost Bear is something we've never seen before.
Yeah.
It's a 2D platformer in VR. Mm-hmm. It's like, thank you for giving us something that we've never seen, and like, mm-hmm. something that somebody was willing to take a risk on.
Yeah.
I'm thrilled, even if at an hour long.
Sure.
I want longer games, for sure.
Yeah. Right.
But this is fine in the meantime.
Okay.
Yeah. Who's up?
Adam Henson.
Oh, Europe.
Asia.
Europe.
China.
Damn it. Adam Henson from Viewer TakeOver.
Hey, Adam Henson.
Hey, Adam.
Oh, Henson. Sorry, I said Henson.
Hansen. Hey, whatever happened to them? Anyways.
Oh, that's okay. He says, hey, Brian. Love the show and everything you guys do for the PSVR community. Thanks. We love you too. Ah. What are your guys' thoughts on games that add some PSVR content? Quotes. I feel a lot of them aren't polished enough and end up turning away potential PSVR players due to their lack of quality.
Huh? Yeah, I don't know. I don't like it either.
Hmm. Yeah.
You know, games like Motor Racer 4, were like, hey, here's your PlayStation VR content. And it was like, oh, get to race around these tracks with no opponents.
Yeah, yeah.
Like, that's not what I was looking for.
Yeah.
And especially the biggest problem with added VR content, instead of just having the full game in VR, is that they never specify what you're actually getting.
Yeah.
Right.
It's never like, oh, you just get some practice tracks.
Yeah.
No, it's like, well, you didn't tell us that I just spent $40 on this game and
I didn't know what I'm getting before I spend the money.
Tekken 7 mm-hmm. did not tell me that there isn't VR in it. There's like one practice mode with no life bars and nothing. You just it's just a practice mode. And I spent $60 on that game so that I could create a let's play of me being pissed off that there's no game here.
Wow. Right.
Yeah.
Tekken 7, amazing game. No VR content.
Right.
Practice modes don't count.
No, they don't.
Yeah, that like, if Tekken 7 was like my first VR experience, mm-hmm. I'd be like, why would anybody want this?
Yeah.
I'd put the helmet on.
This is what we're getting for what we pay for it.
I'd go to my friend's house and try it out and he'd be like, here, check out Tekken 7 in VR. I'd be like, no, thank you. I'm good.
Yeah, not paying
this
that.
This isn't something I want to spend $400 on.
Yeah.
Right.
Yeah. No, I agree with Adam.
Yeah.
Oh, me?
Yeah, yeah, look at that name.
I'm going to say the X is a Z sound, so I'm going to call it Zotico Elf.
There you go.
Because of Viewer TakeOver, I subscribe to the Polish the Polish guy.
Ha.
Yeah. His reviews are fast and to the point, and I like that he makes fun of himself.
Himself.
Is that intentional, you think? And not his perfect English. Like me, he sometimes puts subs, the right English word he should have used, and the made up he created by accident. That was a rough one. And the disabled guy deserves some followers, I think. You know, hold on. Before I finish this comment, the Polish guy is Polish Paul.
Yeah.
Okay. And the handicapped guy, that's the handicapable gamer. Just FYI, they are both very good PlayStation VR YouTubers. I don't know if Zotico Elf was trying to be funny.
I don't
know
if that was the right way to put it. Yeah. But.
I was reading this and I was like, this is a fucking funny comment. Disabled guy deserves some followers, I think. It's useful because it's nice to know if a game needs you to be standing all the time or how much space, etc. Yeah. That's all. I just wanted to give another shout out to Polish Paul and another shout out to Handicapable Gamer. Mm-hmm. You know, you guys are very supportive of the PlayStation VR YouTube community. We appreciate that. Subscribe to everybody. Everybody's voice should be heard. This is an awesome community.
Cool.
Yeah, absolutely.
All right, go up.
All right, from the Lost Bear live stream, this is Slim, either 1212 or 1212. Either way, here he goes. Dude, you're not allowed to play everybody's golf. It's not VR? What?
Yeah.
Oh.
Apparently, I'm not allowed to play non-VR games.
Oh.
Okay, Michelle?
I think you're allowed to.
Yeah, I'm going to anyway, but it will not be a focus, I promise you that. I don't have enough time to play non-VR games. You're not allowed to play.
Yeah. What are you doing buying these games?
Yeah. Dare I. Shame on you.
It looked like fun.
It was right. Fun, actually.
Yeah.
He's right. Saving.
He's hitting.
Nansa Gashus.
Hey, what's up?
Hey.
From PSVR Theater. He should have wrote it like that, too. Get your hand out of here. I'm not sure if you yes, apparently. Ooh. I'm not sure if you succeeded in making the show that you wanted to watch, but You have definitely made a show that I want to watch. Over the weekend, I crave for a new episode, like the most ways that people crave Walking Dead.
Nice.
That's a huge compliment. Yeah,
we are like zombies usually at 12 at night when we record.
Well, more at like 10 a.m.
Or 10 a.m. now, yeah.
Oh, see, that's when I'm...
Yeah. Jacked up.
Yeah.
P.S., you are all annoying.
we did ask. That's
we
fair.
Did ask.
Awesome.
Yeah, and we are.
That's fine. P.S.S., don't ever change. Nice follow-up. Also, I'm strongly debating putting question marks where they don't belong, just to see Jeremy throw up his hands in confusion?
What?
I like that comment.
Yeah.
All around. That's a good one.
Yeah.
Thanks, Nance. Awesome. Awesome compliments.
Yeah.
We really appreciate that, of course.
Yeah.
And yes, we are annoying. A lot of people commented there, like, if you're annoying, then I'm obnoxious. If, you know, everyone basically said, no, you're not annoying. Nansa goes,
yeah, you are.
Yes,
you are.
You're all annoying.
Yes.
And I happen to agree with you, sir.
Yeah.
Or
yeah.
Madam. 140 Chapuin wrote on the weekly wrap-up, yeah, IGN is more irrelevant now a day. Almost feels like there is a hate campaign against PlayStation VR. Anyway, gonna keep playing and enjoying my PlayStation VR. Mm. 140 Chapuin, we thank you for your comment. It is definitely an area of contention right now with mainstream media.
Yeah.
Everyone seems to be hating on VR.
Mm-hmm.
There doesn't seem to be any like real supporters out there.
No,
it's strange. Which is the only reason, like, I think we're so adamant about getting these videos out there. Day after day, just to show our support, just to show how much we love this thing. There always has to be a counterpoint to every point.
Yeah.
What do you guys think? You guys think there's too much hate for PlayStation VR?
There's a little bit.
There's a little bit of hate for sure.
Yeah. All VR, really. It's not just PlayStation VR.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's like, don't you want it to succeed though?
No, some people don't.
So they really don't.
Yep. The Dreamcast guy apparently just hates the damn thing.
Yeah.
But why? Like,
I don't know.
Let that succeed while you play the games that you like to play.
Yeah, I wasn't...
Or the system you like to play.
He's still mad about the Dreamcast. I'm still mad about the Dreamcast.
I was still... Yeah. Yeah, I jumped in on that
boat,
and it was
go.
Discontinued 6 months later. Let's put it that way.
Oh, no, I jumped in after it was discontinued. I got my system for $20.
Oh, wow.
I got a bunch of games for like $5. Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah, that was
I
the
paid
best.
A lot. I paid, you know, 200. Off the shelf for that thing.
Right.
Berserk, Sword of the Berserk, that was great.
That was good.
I played,
think this is the question.
No, anyways, I'm not going to get into it.
Right on. All right, we got to cut this one short. Guys, thank you so much for watching. As always, we love
you
all. It's been a very interesting change of schedule for us this week. But
for all of us.
Yes.
For you guys, for us.
Everybody.
Everybody, all the game cats.
Less sirens out there.
Game cats and game
kitties.
Fewer
sirens, yeah.
Yeah.
The ghetto isn't so scary during the day.
No, actually, I was going to say
on
my ride here.
But still just as loud.
Makes me forget what shitbags live in our town. Because I just, anyways.
As always.
Yeah.
I'm Brian, that's Jeremy, and this is Michelle, and we'll see you next week.
Next week. Ciao, ciao.
I'm not very good at winging it.
I'm going to tell you something, Brian. I understand why when you say you did X amount of takes when you film your litter box episodes and things like that.
Yeah.
Because for some reason, when you just sit here and it's recorded for me, maybe Michelle as well, you just do it and it's done. But when I was home recording that litter box on my own, it changed everything. I was almost like shy and embarrassed and weirded out by it. And, it took me, like, several times, and I deleted maybe 3 or 4
I would
of them.
Think quite the opposite. I would feel more comfortable doing it at home,
oh,
probably.
For real? Yeah.
I, like, feel that Brian's in the other room, and I think he can hear me, and not that, you know,
trying
it's already...
Trying not to. Yeah.
Right, yeah, trying not to. I don't know.
I don't know why I'm so awkward. Used to it, because he's always here listening. When I'm at home, I have a picture of him on my wall, and I, you know, pretend he's listening. Anyways.
He's in my closet.
He's in everybody's closet.
But at least 6,000 people.
Yeah.
Justin Parada's in my closet.